time in life.
In her nearly 8 decades on stage, screen, and television, Ruby Dee worked alongside and influenced some of the biggest names in Hollywood.
It's perfect. It's all perfect.
Her films often address themes of racial inequality head on.
Color people ain't gonna never start getting ahead till they start taking chances on some different kinds of things in this world.
Dee's acting awards and accolades are ample. Her accomplishments off screen, towering.
That felt real good, you know, like you do maybe once or twice in your whole life.
At a time when Hollywood film crews were largely all white, Dee pushed for the employment of Black hairstylists. Simply put, the hair and makeup departments did not know how to style Black hair.
Being a colored woman, I guess I can't help myself now.
Dee did something about it. While filming No Way Out, she took the issue directly to director Joseph Mankiewicz. Shortly after, Elizabeth Searcy was hired to style hair for Dee and her co-star, Mildred Joanne Smith. It was a small but crucial step toward embracing diversity off camera. Ruby Dee's involvement in civil rights traveled far beyond Hollywood locks. From emceeing the 1963 March on Washington with husband Ossie Davis, to being arrested when she was well into her 70s while peacefully protesting the shooting of an unarmed Black man by police. Dee felt she was born into defending human rights.
But I tell you one thing, you're gonna be Black a long time, and you gotta learn to live with it.
Her powerful, poetic words still resonate.
Feminism, communism, here and now, futurism, we just can't afford a schism. We got to get together or die. Now is the time for a evolution. Let's all search and find solution for how we'll make that next revolution or die.